Hey, horse people, we're doing trail loading. I don't know which one I'm gonna do first. I'll probably grab Buddy since his butt's closer and he's being a pain in the butt. Well, you know what? I'm gonna do the way I normally do it. Now, realize I haven't loaded either of these horses in well over, shit, I don't know, a year. Probably checked the videos one the last time. I mean, I've only taken these guys out since they got to all this property and they got run of the mill. I've only taken them off the place maybe two or three times in 3 years. So they don't get trailer loaded a lot. So, and the chickens use this as their house. So I had to clean out all the chicken crap. So, you know, I'm gonna move this hose here so we don't have a distraction. And they'll put standing on it and breaking it. Back up. Just can't get off the hose. Good boy. Buddy messing up the damn program. Mr. T wouldn't have stepped on it, would have stood still. Buddy can't keep his damn leg still because he's freaking a chicken on crack. So, I'm going to load these guys like I normally load them. Mr. T goes in first and Buddy goes in second. So let me untie Mr. T. Hi, Mr. T. I know. I'm just being a pain in the butt. I like using it. I know. Go on, let's get slow around here. I know. He's being a bad boy. Dad will beat him later. Come on. I know. All right. So again, haven't loaded Mr. T and I don't know how long. Shit, I'm sure he just don't walk on it. Come on, Mr. T. I know, you haven't been in here in a while. That's a big scary trailer. You haven't been in here in a while. He's checking out his area. I'm not forcing it. No big deal. I can make him come in 3 seconds if I wanted to. It's not that big of a deal. He'll come in when I give him a little pressure. Good boy. Good boy, Mr. T. Oh, my goodness, Mr. T. Good boy. Oh, he's a good boy. You stop messing up the program. You're going to get beaten. All right. So I'm going to slowly put pressure on him. Remember I talk about squeezing? Getting a horse to move away from pressure. There you go, he moved in. Good boy, Mr. T. Alright, so now Mr. T's in there. And of course, Buddy can't wait to get in because he don't want to be left. Hang on, Mr. T, we're going to get crazy horse in there next. You're a big stinking trouble, I've had it. You're going to get a big beating, I've had it. Alright, so I always on the second horse, because I have this slant, it's always important not to bring the horse in straight and try to turn him because I don't set him up for success. He's kind of like, damn dude, what'd you do? So I always bring him in at this angle so I keep him walking straight. So let's back up, buddy. Like, dude, what are you doing? And again, they ain't been in there in a long time, so they're checking it out. When I cleaned it out, there was 2 or 3 wasp nests in there. A lot of people don't check their horse trailer before they put them in. Wasp nests in there. Once a wasp attacks your horse when you load them in a trailer, you're going to have trailer loading issues. That's a promise. Come on, Mr. Come on. Now watch me bring him in at the best angle I can so I keep him walking in a straight line. And that way he can walk straight on over here. And I can continue that forward movement and he steps up easier. And then at this point, I would tie him up, close the door. Again, if he knows how to push, I gotta be able to push him over a little bit, push him in. I wanna be able to move him when I'm in here. And that's where I come. My other video is about sending, pushing, leading, sending him between two things, making him move to pressure. So this is Buddy. I would put him in and I would shut the door. So now we'll switch him. All right, buddy. Like, dude, that was a short ride. Come on, we're done. He's like, no, I don't wanna leave. Buddy. Now another thing I get is should you make a horse back out? I don't like backing out of a horse trailer. I think it's a pain in the ass. The horse can't see where he's going. It's uncomfortable. I wouldn't like to do it. I like to see where I'm stepping. So that's why I let my horses turn and come on out. I know. All right. So now, let me tie up Killer. Come here, crazy horse. Come here, you red-headed stepchild. All right. I'll just put him on here with a little loop. I don't think he'll go anywhere. If he comes untied, I'll get him. Hey, we're not leaving. We're not leaving. Let's gonna mess up the program, I can see it already. I'm trying to take shortcuts. Instead of going and tying him where he can't get in trouble, I'm setting him up to fail because he wants to come in here, and I'm making my job harder because I'm taking a shortcut. Remember, long way is the fast way, okay? The slow way is the fast way. Hang on, Mr. T, you're still tied up. I know, hang on. Alright, so let me get Mr. T out. And Mr. T won't be that big of a problem. Now Buddy won't have this urge to get in there because he thinks, oh shit, he's still going to want to pull Mr. T away. So let me tie Mr. T around a corner here so he's not too far from Buddy, the big baby. Big peach panty baby. Alright. Come on, you big wimp. Pay attention. You better get over here, you're gonna get a beat. Come on. You're in big trouble. Now you've got to go in the trailer first. Now, I normally put Mr. T forward because he weighs a little bit more than Buddy. So I want my trailer balanced. I don't want the heavy weight in the front or the heavy weight in the back. I want it more balanced. And it tends to do that Mr. T in the front. That's why Mr. T goes in front. It's routine. They're used to it. It keeps it easy. So now I'm messing up routine. I don't think I've ever trailered Buddy in front, Mr. T in back. But I have trailered Buddy by himself, so Buddy has been in front before. So let's get Buddy in here. Come on, killer. Now I can walk him straight in because I can move his butt. I got room. Come here, killer. Hey. Hey, pay attention. Hey, pay attention. You're a big trouble. Go over here. Now, he's trail loaded 1,000 times, and he wanted to back up, and once that foot started going backwards, he was like, I'm ready to go. Why? Quit. Oh, easy. Easy. Now, I'm not paying attention to him. Quit. Easy. Hey. Okay. So, I'm going to untie this halter here, because he's getting too upset. And I could beat his ass, but we're on camera. Easy, 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 easy. Oh, easy. 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 Good grief. So now once I got him trapped to where he's comfortable, I know. Easy. Easy. You're all right. Untied him because I don't want to get him in a problem. And again, I'm doing this fast. I didn't take my time. I ran into a problem. That's good. Good boy, stay there. Buddy's shaking because he's afraid to go. And this just is normal. I gotta console him. Easy, bud. It's okay. I untied him because I normally put him with a face halter. I'm gonna let him come out. I don't want to get him all upset. He's nervous. Easy. Now, I don't ever load them with just a neck halter. Because if I have his nose, I can control his nose and get his body going. With just the neck, he's got his head. And that's the first time I've ever loaded him with a neck halter. And you know what? Didn't work out too well. Could I fix that? I could. I don't need to load him with a neck halter. I don't give a shit. So I don't care if I make mistakes in front of people. People go, oh, you don't know what he's doing. Look at him. I screwed up his horse. Look, I'm going to do just about anything I want with my horses. But you need to realize when you change things, like I changed this, he's stressing. He's yawning. Horses will yawn sometimes when they're stressed. He only had this neck halter, and I didn't like that. He was able to pull and get more leverage. And once he got his head past that point of no return, it was much harder for me to control him. Had I had a nose halter on him and a regular halter, when he pulled it, would have pulled his head, and he wouldn't have got that head in front of his neck. So that's a lesson to be learned. Don't load him, or I need to load him a lot with this so he learns. You know what? You can be loaded with a neck halter. It's not that big of a deal. But I usually have him. You heard him crying in there. That was a stressful cry, and he was shaking. So I didn't want to stress him out anymore. I just didn't think it was that necessary for the video. I can pull him out. I know. He got scared. So he was worried about Mr. T leaving him. I haven't had somebody's going to come here and go, that horse is buddy sour. That guy can't control that horse. He's buddy sour. Whatever. Look, horses like each other. Ain't nothing wrong with that. And I ain't got a problem with it. So I'm going to do a part two, put a regular halter on him, and we'll do this again. And that way you can see the less problems because he doesn't get his head around. So this neck rope is the problem. Actually, a neck rope ain't a problem. I'm the problem for doing it without preparing him or trying it first. Mr. T, what the hell are you doing? Are you trying to get into something now too? All right, we'll end that there.